What's up? We're back in here. We back in here with another one. I'm sinking the shit to my phone right now. Awaken, my love. You're sinking to my phone right now. You filthy slut. You whore. Don't ask me why I'm so vulgar to my laptop. I broke my computer screen like a week ago, and I just bought a replacement and installed it myself because I'm a fucking genius. And the shit took so long, legitimately, I wanted to kill myself and then burn myself. It was not a fun time putting that bitch back in there. It wasn't. Because my love is about to awaken.
This doesn't make any fucking...
Let me just tell you real quick about Snapchat. This is like one of the most unpredictable applications you can ever use. First of all, everybody uses the fucking doggy filter. I mean, what weirdo wants to be a fucking dog? To get that out of the way, let me just get to the real shit that I wanted to talk about. Snapchat is like dick pic city, and I have no idea why. Every time I open my Snapchat, I'm loaded with like a bunch of messages from people, and I'm taking a chance opening every single one because I want to be a nice guy, and I want to unleash my Snapchat life to the world sometimes, but then I'm like, you know what? I remember that dick pic I got a few weeks ago that made me real uncomfortable. I'm not with that shit, so it makes me not want to use the app. Most of the time, it's, you know, normal shit. You know, ass and titties, girls deep-throating bananas and cucumbers, hitting you up in your messages, talking about, oh, yeah, you look so good here. I'm like, okay, yeah, that's fine, whatever, whatever. But then every now and again, you get a dick pic, and it's not normal shit, right? It's always something that's out of the way or unexpected. Like, I got a message from somebody on Snapchat, and the name says Sarah Wilkins, right? I'm thinking, this is a female. I don't have a problem responding. It's just a chat message. Let me go ahead and open that shit. Little did I know, it wasn't just a chat message. It was an attachment with some dude jerking himself with whipped cream. This dude had whipped cream on his dick. I will never get that image out of my head. It is so horrible.
It's honestly traumatizing.
But I got pissed, right? So I disregarded the actual attachment of him stroking his dick with whipped cream. And I was like, yo, do I look fucking weird to you? Like, do I look like I need dick pics in my life? Do I look like I need this shit right now? No, I don't. I'm a normal guy with a normal profile picture. My name on there is normal. My username is normal. I don't have, I like Dick69 as my username. Like, what makes you think I wanted a dick pic? He was like, oh, my bad. I just do shit like that sometimes. I thought you were pretty attractive, so I thought I'd show you what I'm working. I want to see what you're working with. And I honestly started getting angry. Like, I got real mad. You know, like, the dude sent me the dick thing, and I was like, you know what? That's already made me mad. But what made me even more mad is the fact that you're using whipped cream as a lubricant and actually coming at me like this makes sense right now. Not gay and not want to see that shit, but you fucking milking your dick with whipped cream. You don't do that. Then he started trying to come at me like I have a problem for disliking what he was doing. He's like, oh, so you got a problem with whipped cream? What type of nigga are you? I'm like, are you? You put the dick in my DM, basically, and you coming at me like I did something wrong? Fuck you! I'm just saying, with Snapchat, it's always something weird, okay? You never open your shit up and get regular shit. Snapchat, I don't fuck with you. You need to get your shit together, alright? Or at least make it so you can see a preview of what you're about to open. This way, you at least have a chance to be like, you know what, nah, I'm blocking this dude. I don't even want to respond. No, Snapchat makes it so you can't see a preview or nothing. You just go in blind, and whatever you see is whatever you see. So be careful. I just had to get that off my chest, but now we're about to get in Now we're about to get into Childish Gambino's brand new project called Awaken My Love. You guys got on me in the last video I did for Childish Gambino. I mispronounced the album, called it Me and Your Momma. First track was so deep embedded in my mind that I thought that was the album name. So I know now, but I made a mistake. Roll with it. And because of the internet, I'm going to react to this next album, Awaken My Love by Childish Gambino. Let's get it. First track, Me and Your Momma. Hold up. Oh. 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 Damn. that first track had me speechless because I really love that cut. That was so good on production. A lot of sounds in there that you would have to give a couple listens to recognize everything in there. But I know you guys also told me that he produces some of his own tracks, so I wonder if that's something that he produced. I don't know if that's something to foreshadow that this is going to be an album that's going to have a lot of different sounds, or if it's something to just kind of stroke his own ego, basically saying, I know how to make a really dope sounding track. Track number two, Have Some Love. Some nice sound. I get where he's going with this, but two tracks in, it's a little difficult. I will admit, it's a little difficult for a first listener who's getting into Childish Gambino or somebody who is used to his old way of performing. It's a little difficult trying to get into this and be completely satisfied. Now, for me, I know how to appreciate good music, but for the masses, this might be a little bit difficult for him to get into. So we're going to go to track number three called Boogieman. I definitely enjoyed that track number two. It had one of those vibes of old school tranquility. Track number three, Boogieman. A little bit as I kept listening to it, but like I said, so far listening to this album, you are really missing Childish Gambino, and that could be a starlight for this thing, because it could be him saying that I don't need to be the front center of the project for it to be enjoyable. So I like the concept that he's going for, so we're gonna see where he takes it with the next track called Zombies.
All I see is zombies walking all around us.
Here we go.
You can hear them coming. All I see is zombies. Hear them screaming loud. Munch your soul.
Ooh.
Here they come behind you.
Ooh, I like these lyrics. Oh. So far, that's my favorite track. I guess that's his way of describing the media and people today, is they look for what they can get from you. He's basically not referring to literal zombies, but their behavior is very zombie-like because they're always looking to suck the blood and the life out of you. They're trying to take your life away, basically. Not kill you, but take away your enjoyment or fulfillment of life. Next track, Riot. Going a whole lot of places. That track was a little hit or miss for me. I definitely did see the strong points of it, which is heavy in production, playing on kind of a nostalgia. I just think for an album that's only 11 tracks that are as short as that kind of seem like interludes aren't really necessary, but that's me, my opinion. I definitely feel like he took it back to the original place that the album started with that track. Not a bad track, but when you listen to it, how much substance do you feel, or how much meaning do you feel listening to that track? I want to know. Track number six, Redbone. Is this a sample? This sounds like fucking, I'd rather be with you, cool. Yeah, I'd rather be with you. Oh, this definitely sounds like it. Some Boosty Collins? Ooh. Sound like some Bootsy Collins, bruh. Oh.
This is the one. This right here, I know it. That sounds disgusting. This is my favorite track on the album. What happened? Oh hell, this is the one. Ooh, I'm sweating.
That track, if it doesn't put you in a mood, it'll put you in this state of mind where you're just relaxed completely. Just chill mood to where I felt like, you know what? This is taking off the clothes, making out, grabbing and groping certain areas to get into it. There's a part where you're like, just close your eyes and listen to the song and tell me you don't imagine raw dogging the soul out of somebody. Track number 7, California. She must have fucking lost her mind. Say it, how you doing? You did it. I'ma show you what it done, but enough of a finish. I don't know why, but this reminds me of like a very, very, very back in the day Lil Wayne, if he was Jamaican. He's using the I like that. That was a pretty nice track to kind of put you in the mood. I see people listening to that. It's a really bright, sunny day, especially if you're in California. It was one of those, I guess, laid back. I think you can get high to the song, honestly. So, scratch what I said. You might be able to get high to that song. Track number 8, Terrified. What are you terrified of? Is it dick pics in your Snapchat? Because if it is, I completely understand. People watch you underground. I'm going to eat you alive. From that track, I think I understand more of the concept of this album now. I think moody music, that's what I feel like it is. It's music that has a touch of nostalgia, but it's also really, really moody. It's got that type of, it's supposed to give you a feeling. It's not supposed to be something that you just listen to. It's supposed to actually change your mood, I feel like, and deliver the mindset, the raw material. I think it's supposed to actually give you a picture of something else. Not just listening to it, I think it's supposed to give you the audio so that you can visualize and kind of interpret for what you want. You know, it's really open for interpretation in my opinion. That's why I think it's so limited on lyrics. I actually like the way that sounds now. If you interpret the way that I do, it actually sounds really, really good. Next track, Baby Boy. Little hey. Damn! My body is just so hot. Pause. But you know what I'm saying. This album's getting me high. Damn. That voice at the end, I wouldn't have mind hearing throughout the entire track, but another album, again, that delivers a feeling to you. That time, I was just getting so high to the music, I wasn't even visualizing anything. I just had my fucking eyes closed looking like an idiot. But it was a track that, even if you aren't thinking about anything, it still hits you, you know what I mean? And those are one of those soothing, old school, just laid back. Next track, The Night Me and Your Mama Met. Wait a minute! Let me look at these tracks again.
At this point, I start wondering if these tracks mean that someone is speaking to their child.
Wait a minute, hold up. Is this... Is he... Okay, no, I got a concept idea. For all you... A lot of you keep asking me why I look this way. I have a screen, like my TV, a TV screen right here. And I just look at the visual effects, like, of the album. Like, I look at the screen, but I have the album cover right there. So I always look at it just because... I don't know, it's a nice reference point while I'm listening to the music. I don't know why, I just like looking over there. See, listening to this track, the title makes sense. You know what I mean? Listening to this track, you can literally see two people meeting, and that's how the kid was formed. You can literally see this being that track. And we have the final track on here called Stand Tall. Flash before my eyes. You can't tell me this man don't sound like Frank Ocean. You cannot fucking tell me that. I feel like a child, keep all your dreams, keep standing tall. If you are strong when you can. When you can. Sing that shit, Donald. We may cry. Sing that alone, shit. I feel we know. So, this man, and he's incorporating new music with the old feeling. He's incorporating new auto-tune with and he's using it well. I do. That smooth ass transition. Oh my god. This is just a joy to listen to right now. That was Childish Gambino, Awaken My Love. This was not your basic run-of-the-mill album. This is one of those albums that I think a lot of people may have to listen to a couple times to just appreciate all the instrumentation, all of the intention that were behind the creation of this body of work. In my opinion, I thought that this concept idea was created more so to give people who kind of can interpret things for themselves, like a listener who doesn't always need the artist to do all the work for them. Because a lot of the times, and this is a genius idea if this is what he was going for, Donald, I'm talking to you. If this is what you were going for, the feeling that I get from this album is something that gives me freedom to take my thoughts wherever I want them while listening to this album. I listen to a lot of projects, and most of the time, the artists, I'm not saying this in a negative way, but they're selfish enough to the point where they would literally take your experience and force their own experience onto you while they're rapping and while they're singing on some of these tracks. He doesn't do that. He allows you to have that freedom to think for whatever you want to. Of course he's delivering a mood with the music. He's delivering a certain sound that's supposed to get you to think a certain way, but it's not to the point where he's forcing his own agenda or his own mindset on you while you're listening to the tracks. It's something that's supposed to be up for interpretation. It wasn't created just for the sole purpose, in my opinion, of, oh, listen to my idea, I'm gonna shove it down your throat. Like, he really allowed for expressiveness throughout this entire project. A lot of the tracks on here carry an old school vibe. A lot of them carry a 90s or even actually 70s and 80s kind of feel to them. My favorite being Redbone, where it kind of sounds like it could be like an Erykah Badu song. And it's one of those tracks where, although, like I said, it's up for interpretation, you still know the mood behind it. The music is just so laid back and chill to the point where you feel like you can listen to this whole thing and know for a fact that nothing's gonna get ruined. The mood's not gonna get ruined. Their thoughts aren't gonna get ruined. It's gonna be consistent to the point where you trust Donald. He made you put your trust in him with this album. On the track Baby Boy, it's got like this old school blues type vibe to it. I mean, it's so raw and it's very hard hitting. It's emotional. It's not over the top. The lyrics aren't over the top. They're not anything too crazy, but it drives home the idea, Baby Boy. You know, the intro starts with small hands, small feet. And from the track titles themselves, it's almost as if someone's explaining to their child why they were born or how they were born or the feelings and emotions that led up into them being born. You got another cut on here called Zombies where he's kind of explaining how a lot of people in today's society behave like zombies without actually knowing it. Zombies isn't just a term that's meant for dead people walking. It's meant for also people out there who want to take your life away from you without actually killing you, and that could turn you into a zombie. Continue to repress that feeling that you have people around you who are just trying to suck you dry. You will end up becoming like one of them, like a walker, like a zombie pretty much. He's got a guitar in the beginning of it that's kind of pulling you into what the track's gonna sound like. It sounds very mellow and kind of ominous while it brings you into this track that's just so kind. It's actually very meaningful that has the lyrics to back the ominous feeling in the background. One of the tracks on here sounded like it could have been off a cut from To Pimp a Butterfly. There was another track on here that I particularly, I didn't mind, but I did kind of, he included a track on here that was almost under 2 minutes, and like I said, to have an album that's 11 tracks long, to have a track on there that's not really feel long enough, or I guess powerful enough to deserve its short length. I kind of just threw this shit on here just because I can. I don't know if that's necessarily the vibe that he was going with, but it definitely seemed like it's one of those tracks on there that wasn't really too necessary to the point of the album, but it was something on there for certain people to listen to, I suppose. I definitely don't think that this was too far of a stretch from his last project because of the internet. I feel like it's definitely a step in a new direction, at least for Childish Gambino, as far as I'm concerned. I guess passionate to him, because there's no way you can make tracks like these and not be passionate about the certain music that you listen to. He was very selfless, in my opinion, with this thing, because there were a lot of cuts on here where you could literally close your eyes and visualize whatever you want for that track, and it makes sense. This thing was beautifully produced. I feel like he really captured his essence, in a sense, when with this. Couple negatives about this album is all the tracks tend to end in the same way, with them all fading out. A lot of the tracks on here may not meet people's standards, and what I mean by that is people may expect a certain Gambino and they may not get him with this album. I understand that, but for somebody like me who appreciates the evolution of an artist, I have to give him a pass with this. Childish Gambino, Awaken My Love, in my opinion, gets it definitely a really dope listen. It's available on iTunes, so if you want to go ahead and cop it, I definitely recommend it. It's definitely an experiment, so if you're looking for something new to listen to, I would definitely recommend this one. Now that we got that out of the way, I found out that J. Cole is releasing a project next week. I am so excited. So many of you guys asked me to do Friday Night Lights. So many of you asked me to do Born Sinner. Some of you asked me to do 2014 Forest Hill Drive. I listen to every single J. Cole project there is. There's nothing you can tell me about J. Cole. Nothing. But when I heard this shit this morning, it got in my soul. It got to my heart. It pulled at all my heartstrings, and it let me know there is a God, and he loves me. Next Friday, J. Cole. It's all about J. Cole, okay? Post Malone, you fucked me back in September when I thought your album was gonna drop. You fucked us all. Back in August, actually, when I thought your album was gonna drop. You fucked us all over. You did this shit. So you're gonna be reviewed the next day. J. Cole, Friday is all about you, bruh. It's all about you. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you thought about this project, Awaken My Love, and I will see you in the next one. Peace. Oh, man, again, this is why I don't sit down, because my ass hurts. Pause.